I'm Kate Zimmerman. I'm the Chief Data Scientist at HawkEye 360. So I'm focused on building out our data science, our machine learning and analytics portfolio on our RF data. RF data offers a unique lens through which we can look at the world. Within a HawkEye 360 collection, it can span millions of kilometers. So we can survey these very large areas for RF energy on the Earth. As we produce more geolocations, being able to find that data point that you need that's interesting or relevant to your mission area is becoming a little bit more challenging. And as we launch more constellations of satellites and expand our signal catalogs, that number is going to continue to grow. AI provides this ability to scale, to look through all the data, to help kind of pinpoint which data points are most relevant for our end users as quickly as possible. So we're building a whole set of AI algorithms that are going to help kind of narrow in on which areas that, you know, might have the highest value for your use case. We're also, you know, evaluating where we can use AI internally to improve our geolocations, to be able to downlink more information and data, to overall improve our data quality across our products. How can we make our, you know, RF geo ellipses smaller, our data points as accurate as possible? We see AI as being an enabler that can help make that process faster, more efficient. On the data science team here at HawkEye 360, we're really focused on building out what I call like our three big technology priorities. The first area is data fusion. So we're trying to understand how we can bring in different data modalities and fuse that together for our customers so that they can derive context around what this geolocation may mean for their respective missions. So our analytics combined with other people's analytics only gives you deeper insights into what is actually happening in your area of interest or the mission questions that you're trying to kind of find answers to. We're also building out a very big advanced analytic tool suite, being able to detect things though in different data domains and correlating that back to an RF geo so that analysts can have a more complete picture of what might be going on in their area of interest. The third thing that we're really focused on is data exploration. So our approach is extremely analyst focused. We're getting rid of the parts that are tedious and get in the way of the actual analysis they're trying to conduct. We're going to take care of that so that for the end users, you know, their experience will just be the most seamless kind of analysis platform as possible.